Friends, welcome to the English Club. I am standing here to deliver a short notes or simply a speech on women empowerment. Actually, this topic, the women empowerment, the literal meaning of this topic is to empower women, social, political, economic, demographic, and cultural aspect. The question of women empowerment lies in the patriarchal societies. And as we know that we live in a patriarchal society. Patriarchal society literally means a male-dominated society. In this society, we need to empower a woman. And the literal meaning, to empower, that means to get some powers or to transfer some powers to the women. But we look about our ancient past. In the Rigvedic period, there is no concept of women empowerment. Although we live in patriarchal societies, in Vedic times, or particularly in Rigvedic times, women take part in political organization called Sabha and Samiti, and they took decisions, or they participate in decision making. And the condition of a woman is quite good in early Rigvedic period. But what happens to the later Vedic period? The condition or situation of a woman becomes declined, and in consequent phases or in the latter phases, the condition of a woman get declined to a great extent. What happens to the another period? We live in a civilized society, but what happens in patriarchal society? Every political, social, economic, and demographic decision were taken by the male member. Although female can advise him, but male try to dominate in every aspects. That's why we need a feel to empower a woman to take political decision, social decision, economic decision, demographic decision, to empower in every sector. And at the recent phase, it is a big question among the developed and developing countries, how to empower a woman. Because men and women are equally potential resources to advance economic growth. I saw a practical example of many developing countries in which women empowered, they have a political, social, and economic rights, and they use as a resource to advance the economic growth of a country. That's why we need to develop the civilized society, and for this reason, we have to empower the women. And education is the most powerful thing by which we can empower a woman. But there is another aspect. First of all, we should have educate owners on a large scale, or basically we have to attain a 95% literacy rate. Then after, we have to teach about the cultural aspect of our society. Indian culture and Indian society is quite different from the societies of global world. So we have to take a responsibility to empower a woman, also empower a woman in cultural aspect. Then we have to move towards the economic aspect of our life. That's why I say that women empowerment is the need of time, and we should take care of this decision in a practical ground. If we take this decision on practical ground, then we become advanced and we have reached our glorious parts. That's all.
Thank you, sir, for such a nice and beautiful speech made on one of the burning issues of our modern time or modern India, that we call human empowerment. Actually, this topic has become one of the most discussed topic in present scenario. Either it is a part of politics, either it is a part of schools, college, university, everywhere, even in a small society, the most important thing is to empower our women. Friends, you have just listened to him from the origins of human empowerment to the present scenario. Okay, but right now there is a question in all intellectuals that still in the present era, in the present situation, are women have given the equal opportunity to the men? The answer sure comes, it's not possible, it is not equal. The opportunities, the offers, the ideas, the powers which a man has allowed to use were not given equally to the girls. In that time, we need to change our mindset. Girls, women and men, both are equal. They are a part of society, and until we give the equal opportunity to the women, or you may say the girls,
our society cannot be considered as a developed one, even in the past, even in the present scenario. So empowering women is not compulsory, but considered, should be considered by everyone. It is our duty to treat girl, to treat women in proper way or equally is our duty. So that's all. That's a very important thing, sir. You have discussed here before the camera with confidence, the instructor background, social, everything. So I hope, friends, you enjoyed today's speech. That's all. Thank you.